morning, the New York Times ran a story that surprised a lot of people. Your recycling gets recycled, right? Maybe or maybe not. And the gist of this, we used to send tons and tons of our recyclables to China, but because of new anti-pollution regulations in the People's Republic, they don't want to import garbage anymore. Without that market, a lot of our recyclable paper and plastic is ending up in landfills. That's not great for the planet. But where others see problems, I see opportunities to help you try to make money, which brings me to Covanta Holding, CVA, a waste disposal company that has a huge waste-to-energy business. Every year, they convert about 20 million tons of trash into clean, renewable power, while also recycling roughly 550,000 tons of metal. Even if Covanta doesn't take anything from the China garbage buildup, the very fact that we're practically swimming in trash here is good for their business. Now, the company just reported a strong quarter at the end of April, but the stock has struggled to gain traction here. It's down about 5% year to date. So will it continue to languish, or could this stock turn out to be the proverbial trash to treasure asset? And by the way, it's got a very high yield. Let's take a closer look with Stephen Jones. He's the president and CEO of Covanta Holdings. Get a better sense of his company's prospects. Mr. Jones, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you,
sir.
Thanks,
Jim. Appreciate
Thank you. Thank you for coming
back
on. All right, first, you probably read that New York Times story.
Yes, I did.
This is obviously good news for your company, right?
Yeah, it is. So China in early 2018 put in something called the policy called the National Sword Program. And it basically what they've said is they don't want to take contaminated plastics, recycled plastics and paper. And so if it's contaminated, they're rejecting it. And so that's caused a kind of backup in the recycling industry here in the U.S.
So but some of that like contaminated, like, for instance, you guys have a good business in medical waste.
Right.
So, I mean, I think you're probably ready to handle some of this bad plastic.
So our preference is to have the recycled material get recycled. I'm sure you're at home religiously putting your plastic in the plastic bin, paper in the paper bin. So you like to have it recycled. I think it's a shame, as you mentioned in the intro, for this to be being buried into a landfill.
Right.
At a minimum, you should recover the BTU content that's in the plastic and paper.
Right.
And so an energy from waste plant allows that to happen. You can recover those BTUs.
But now, Mr. Fish from Waste Management has often said on our show that we're actually not great recyclers like some of other countries. Like I was subject of what the equivalent of a citizen's arrest because I put a brown bottle in a green trash can in Germany. I mean, can we ever get serious in this country, or are you still okay?
Well, it's interesting. I think this China National Sword Program is showing that we don't have some of the infrastructure here in the U.S. to handle our own plastics and paper that was going to China. So roughly 70% of the exported plastics and paper were going to China, and that's largely shut off at this point. So what you're seeing is that, first off, the business model for someone like Jim, the business model's changing for recycling.
Yes.
And then secondly, a lot of this recycled material needs a home, and one of the homes it's finding is landfills, which I think a lot of people would be disappointed to hear.
But people have to know that Covanta, your principal source of revenue is the trash, not necessarily the energy.
Right. So if you look at our revenue streams, waste is 70% of our revenues in that neighborhood.
Right.
And as we reported in the first quarter, volumes were up about 6% on waste. And so, and that was before the China National Sword Program really took major effect. So it's a good time to be in the waste industry, particularly if you're on the disposal side of the value chain.
Now, those of us in the New York area know that we passed this 91st Street Marine Transfer Terminal. That's a big piece of business for you.
Yeah, so we have one marine transfer station already online. That's the Queens Marine Transfer Station.
Okay.
The 91st Street, we got the notice to proceed on that transfer station. And so we're in the process now of buying equipment. That'll start up about Q1 of 2019.
Okay, now I have a friend who's in an outfit called Aero Aggregates, and they take green glass.
Mm-hmm.
And they're using it to be able to make it so that it's fill for roads, much cheaper than aggregate. Are you doing for various different entities? Are you sorting for them, or is all your stuff sorted and then made into something else?
So we take most of our materials post-recycling.
Okay.
The area where we recycle is on metals. So there's a lot of metals that come through the waste stream. So we reclaim enough steel to build 6 new Golden Gate bridges every year.
Wow.
We reclaim 3 billion aluminum cans a year. So I'm not sure what's going on, but there must be a lot of beer drinking going on out there for 3 billion cans to come through the waste stream. And we only take about 5% of the U.S.'s waste stream. So
but you're still
there's a lot of metal.
I mean, you're very large.
Yeah.
Now, last question. I know that it has more to do with the stock price, but when I see a 6% yield, some people say, well, wait a second, that can't be sustained. But you've got easily the cash flow to sustain that yield.
So this year we're a little challenged on cash flows in that we entered into, we sold half of our Dublin waste energy facility.
Right, you've got a UK
so
too.
Yeah, so we sold that to the Green Investment Group, who is now owned by Macquarie. That allowed us to deal with some issues. One issue we had talked about last time I was on, which was our leverage ratios were going up. So
right.
We were able to bring our leverage ratios down by selling this 50% equity. But we did sell 50% of the EBITDA and 50% of the free cash flows. That's a short-term phenomenon.
Right.
As we look out now with our partnership with the Green Investment Group, we're expecting to double free cash flow over the next 5 to 7 years to about $250 million of free cash flow per year.
Second. Okay, good. I feel better because I also know your same-store sales going up, so I'm not as concerned, but that's terrific. Okay, that's Stephen Jones. He's president and CEO of Covanta Holdings, doing the right thing with our trash. Mad Money's back after the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.